If you find yourself losing sleep over politics, you're not alone. One in seven American adults, roughly 34 million people, are admitting getting a lack of shut-eye over our current roller coaster-like political landscape. All that tossing and turning and late-night hair pulling, thinking about Trump's winning, is affecting 20% of those with a college degree and 9% of those with a high school degree or less. The hardest hit, younger baby boomers, ages 54 to 63, are the most likely age group to lose sleep over America's political climate. Greg, does this surprise you?
That emphasis on baby boomers. it's not surprised people in college are more affected by this because they're too close to the fire. The fire being politics. I would rather be losing sleep over Trump's tweets than North Korea dropping a bomb on us. So I'll take these present day problems over problems of the past. The media has a lot to blame for this. Every day is the apocalypse. If the newspapers were honest, they would run a daily correction every day saying, yesterday we said the world would end. We regret the error. Because they really would regret the error.
Dana, I think the issue is social media for a lot of people, because when you're on Twitter, and that's why I wrote my book, hashtag Do Not Disturb, endorsed by Dana Perino, by the way. But no, I think the issue is that you're on Twitter and you see this constant flow of information all the time. There's no break. Then you go to Facebook. Then you go to all of the websites and you're inundated and people aren't able to process information at that pace anymore. So they kind of start to lose their minds, myself included. Is that?
Yeah, being more disciplined about putting your things away, your phones or your emails, whatever, however you get your emails on your laptop is better. I also would say that people ages 54 to 63, they're generally, that's the age when you start being unable to sleep. And it doesn't really have to do with politics.
True.
It has to do with age. So I think that people are just making up an excuse. There's not a woman my age I know who actually sleeps really well every night. And it's not because of politics. It's just because we're human.
That's so true. I'm up at 3 a.m. exactly. And then I wander around the apartment for until I fall asleep.
I'm not even going to ask what you do in that.
You don't want to know. Neither do the police.
Now, Juan, you're immersed in politics all day long, obviously, reading. What do you do to keep sane? Does the news ever, does the Trump news ever drive you insane? I mean, that face alone tells a million stories.
Well, I haven't slept since November of 2016. I'm trying to put it together. I'm working. The psychologist says, now, what happened? What could it be? Because, I saw that the psychologists are having a meeting out in San Francisco, and they have here at Jedediah 15 symposiums on what Trump has done to the American mind. And it talks about people who say they feel hopeless, people who say they have no control, people who say they're now fearful because of Trump. And so I've been trying to figure it out, with the psychiatrist, and I thought, well, maybe if I took a sleeping pill. But if I took the sleeping pill, then I'd miss Trump destroying me.
Oh.
So I can't do that because I want to be alert. I want to know what he's doing.
Got to sleep with one eye open to see what
he's doing. Yeah, all this tossing and turning and the blankets on the floor. But the only problem is, the wife doesn't like it.
Uh-oh.
What are you gonna do?
Do you sleep?
Z-Quil.
No, I mean, I was up all last night thinking about Bruce Orr. Think about it. What's so funny? He's hiding meetings with Chris Steele from the FBI, hiding payments to Nelly Orr, his wife, from Fusion GPS, yet the media is not covering it. And I'm thinking, why is the media not covering
this
it?
This is what you thought about.
This is what was keeping me up last
better?
Night. And money.
And money.
And money. I don't make as much as Greg, so it's driving me crazy. And I'm stressed out. Stress. I might actually buy a llama. It's an emotional support pet.
No. I have an idea.
Can I bring that on the plane?
Wait. I read that Jill Abramson, who used to run the Times, has an Obama doll in her purse.
Oh.
Yes.
Like a voodoo doll or like an actual doll?
No, as a comfort.
Ooh, okay.
Stop. Come on.
I should get that.
This is true.
Oh, my gosh.
Because she says, it's unbelievable what's happened in the country. So she looks back to the last time we had a competent, able president as a source of comfort.
That's the first, an Obama doll. That's a first for me. All right.